Hello again, everyone. It's Taikenzor, and I have not been making tutorials for quite some time, but don't worry, I haven't got any rust yet. So let's get into it. So this time around, I'm going to be going through the cutter module. It's located in your module library, and it's this little guy here, the cutter module. I'm pretty much also going to be doing another rig. It's for an eyeball this time around, so I hope you're looking forward to that. This is pretty much what we're going to be doing. It seems simple enough, doesn't it? But let's say, for example, you want to do something for a character, which will rig an entire body, an eye, kind of like how I did it, would be necessary. The network isn't exactly some simple drawings either. It's more like this. And you probably might think to yourself, why would you need to do this much just for a simple eye? Well, my question to you is, why not? You got lots of capabilities in the software, so might as well try them out, huh? So hopefully, if you're watching this, you're not a beginner. I would suggest that you go through the previous videos, the startup videos, as well as the tools and the arm rigging, because this is pretty much a continuation of that. So let's get into it. So first things first, I'm going to create a new project. Call this one I. That's what we're going to be doing. I've got I cutter. Cutter. With the same default that I usually use, NTSC, and choose create. I want to do this tutorial in stages. One, we draw and peg. Next, we do the hierarchy and the cutter module, and then we go into drawing substitutions, as well as the color override, which will probably be done in the second video. So pay keen attention, this is all just for you. So first thing I want to do is make sure that my colors are in order. I don't need this, or, well, I'll need that. But I'm just going to rename some of these. Black, I'll call this one pupil, I'll call white sclera. And I need a color for my iris, as well as another color for the light. No, just in case you want to decorate your eyes. So one more color for my iris. And I'm going to double click on that. Choose something brown, seeing as my real eye colors are brown. I think this is a decent one. And so you're probably going to need at least two layers for most people, and, well, three if you want to actually do a separation of both, of all parts of the eye, the sclera, the pupil, and the iris. So let's get this done. So you could either draw with your ellipse tool, or if you want, you can always go hand. I like drawing with my hand, so I'm going to be using the brush tool and create my two drawing layers. So first thing I want to do is draw my sclera. So I'm going to get myself a nice outline. Right? Now this isn't perfect, so I'm just going to smooth it out in the tool properties. And just do a little bit of cleanup here. So that looks clean enough to me. And so I'm going to fill in the color for my sclera here. And I'll just rename this layer sclera. Yeah. Okay. Kind of huge, isn't it? I'm just going to turn on my safe area also, just so I can find out where the center is. So
Turn on my safe area for my camera, just so I know where I'm aiming at. And the safe area basically is this, the safest area for you to have all your action in your animation. So if you're doing a full blown animation, just like on TV where you have those little edges, and some TVs have those little borders, they're giving you basically an estimate of what would be the safest area for you to put your action. So if anything, your actual physical TV won't clip out where the good stuff's happening. So one more drawing, Leo, and that will be my iris. So here we go. Iris. Well, aren't you gorgeous? I'll smooth you just a little bit because you look nice already. And now we need the center. Pupil. Some black there. And that's a decent eye. Right. So we have iris and sclera, and the pupil and the iris are in the same spot. You know, you could actually change your iris size, and you could change the color immediately. I'm just going to change mine to a gradient, since I think it would look nicer that way. Let's make this a little lighter. Make it a radial. And I'm just going to edit this. Bring it in. So how's that? That looks decent. We'll just put it around. Look kind of weird, wouldn't it? I'll just keep it this way. So now we have an eye. And now, if you remember, just like in the rigging of the arm video tutorial that I have, you'd want to add your pegs. But before you do, we kind of want to make sure that we don't animate using the drawings themselves. We want to only use pegs to animate. So we go on our properties, clicking on that little box, go to advanced and change this from animate using animation tools and uncheck that box. And do the same for our sclera. And so before you probably saw some pluses beside them, but now they're gone, which means you can't do anything with them. And now we add our pegs. Pegs are easy. You just click on the add peg button. Make sure you click on the right layer. Creates a peg named after that layer. Do the same here. And so we have our pegs for our drawings. And if we use our transformation tool, notice I can move my, I have my iris selected, I can move that around. I have my sclera, I move that around too. So here's the hierarchy, really simple. Just attach the iris to the sclera. So when I move my sclera, all the eye moves, and I can move my iris by itself. Okay, so that's the first part. So the next part, I'm going to go through the cutter tool, right? The cutter tool as well as the color override. So see you then. Y'all take care and God bless.